A very good morning to everyone present here. Today we have a lecture demonstration on Indian classical dance Kathak by Shri Karan Gangani ji, disciple of Pandit Guru Rajendra Kumar Gangani ji. Shri Karan Gangani ji had got a scholarship from Sahitya Kala Parishad from 2008 to 2010 and a national scholarship from Ministry of Culture from 2013 to 2015. He has performed in several festivals in India like Bangalore International Arts Festival, Indo-Ocean Dance Festival in Kolkata, Kathak Mahotsav, Youth Festival and many more. He also has several international performances in countries like China, Israel, Germany, UK and more. So now let's please welcome Shri Karan Gangani ji.
Good morning. First of all, I would like to thank all the higher authorities of AFGGI, Principal Ma'am and Mr. Sandeep Madhukarlal Parihar for organizing such an important topic workshop for the dance and all the students of school. I would like to talk on the behalf of Natya Shastra first. Natya Shastra is the first book which was written by Bharat Muni. In between the 200 BCE to 200 CE. But there is a conflict in between Sanskrit scholars. Some of the Sanskrit scholars, they claim that it has a footprint of dance first found in 500 BCE in between 500 CE. And this is the only book from Veda we have in our Indian mythological history. In Natya Shastra, there are 6,000 poses or sculptures, which is divided into 36 chapters, and the book is all about dance. Now, secondly, I would like to talk about the style or the forms of dance. In Indian mythology, it is divided into four sections. First section, or you can say the Pravati. First is the one Avanti, which is said Ujjaini or the Central India. Second one is Dakshinatya, which belongs from the south. Third one is Panchali, which is north or west. And the fourth one is Audra or Magadhi, which is from the east. There are eight certified dance forms, which is certified from the Ministry of Culture or Sangeet Natak Academy. First dance form is, which is recognized as the Indian classical dance, is Bharatanatyam, and that belongs from Tamil Nadu. Second one is Kathak from Northern India. Third one is Kathakali from Kerala. Fourth one is Kuchipudi from Andhra Pradesh. Fifth one is Odissi from Odisha. Sixth one is Kshetriya from Assam. Seventh one is Manipuri from Manipur. And the eighth one or the last one is Mohiniyattam from Kerala. Now we talk about little bit about the Kathak dance. Kathak dance is the one of the classical dance which is most famous dance or most used dance in normal times or the present period in India. Kathak is divided into three schools of training. First one is Jaipur Gharana, from where I belong. Second one is Lucknow, from the Uttar Pradesh. And third one is Banaras. And recently one Gharana is added, that is Raigarh. Banaras is a mixture of both gharanas, both major gharanas of dance, Kathak dance, Jaipur and Lucknow. Now I talk little bit about the Jaipur gharana. Jaipur gharana is started by the Bhanuji. He was the founder of Jaipur gharana. He is the one who has started in Jaipur, and he was very much inspired from Lord Krishna because he used to travel to Vrindavan every year for the prayers and all. In Jaipur Gharana, The famous style or the speciality of Jaipur is footwork and the chakkas. At the same in Lucknow Gharana, the founder of Lucknow Gharana is Pandit Ishwari Prasad Ji. He was the one who started Lucknow Gharana. Lucknow Gharana is more famous about its bhav and the elegance, or you can say the momentum. Banaras is basically, as I have told you, it's a mixture of Jaipur and Lucknow, and it has its own flavor also because it is very famous in the movies time or the Hollywood period, from Bollywood period. It is very much used in Bollywood also. Now I talk about the Jaipur Gharana, as I belong from the Jaipur Gharana. In the training of Jaipur Gharana, we have received from our Guruji, my Guruji, Pandit Sri Rajendra Kumar Gangani Ji. He is a very respected teacher in present time of Jaipur Gharana school. He is a very good dancer, and what I have received from him, it's very important and very, you can say, crucial or fragile work. Because nowadays there are no gharanas, no one is working like that. Everyone is doing everything which is beautiful, and they are taking from our field, we are taking from their field. It's going like this. Gharana's unique work is to use poetry in dance. In Jaipur Gharana we use Ganesh Paran, Lord Ganesha's poetry into dance, Shiv Paran, Lord Shiva's poetry into dance, and Kavit. Kavits are mostly based on the stories of Lord Krishna or the Leelas of Lord Krishna. So these are the important sections which I need to talk to you all about the dance, and I hope that you all will understand what is dance and what is the beauty of dance. So thank you, Sandeep Ji. I wish you a great year, and I wish all the students that you will learn a very good dance from him. Thank you very much.
Sureshan Sudha Ratnam. शाश्वतम कारणम कारणानां अजं शाश्वतम कारणम कारणानां शिवं केवलं भासितं
तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। नमस्कार, दिस इज संदीप मधुकरलाल, HOD इन डांस फ्रॉम सीनियर विंग ऑफ AFGGI. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक आवर स्कूल प्रिंसिपल मिसेस पूनम एस रामपाल मैम फॉर गिविंग अस दिस वंडरफुल अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड लेट आवर थिलक डांस ग्रुप वर्क ऑन सच एन इनोवेटिव प्रोजेक्ट एंड एक्सप्रेस आवर व्यू ऑन डांस. According to me, dance is having the opportunity to be able to pursue expressions and beauty through the movement and imagination and bring people together with creativity and music. Also, there is much more to know in this field as it is also takes an dancer to have a healthy life, which includes exercise, food and positive mental health. First, if we talk about exercise, your dance should have some sort of cross training with it. Also, exercise increase our stamina and ability to perform well. If we talk about diet, a diet is something we need to ponder on. Firstly, we must have a balanced diet. Having said that, I personally believe dancers should have everything what the country offers. You just have to be careful what you are eating, how much you are eating, and when you are eating, as that's what a balanced diet is called according to me. Dancing can improve your mood while you learn, move and perform. In fact, many people take dance classes because they put them in a good mood and positive mood. Dance plays a very, very important role in keeping your mental health in check इनफैक्ट लोग डांस इसलिए भी सीखते हैं या करते हैं ताकि उनका मूड अच्छा रहे और वो पॉजिटिव बने रहे। तो आइए इस इंफॉर्मेशन के साथ हम लोग अपनी नेक्स्ट मूवमेंट की तरफ चलते हैं, जिसमें हम आपको परफॉर्मेंस के बारे में दिखाएंगे, म्यूजिक, डांस और ये सब बातें किस तरह मिक्स एंड मैच होती है। आइए, डाइट इज समथिंग वी नीड टू पॉन्डर ऑन। फर्स्टली वी मस्ट हैव अ बैलेंस्ड डाइट। हैविंग सेड दैट, आई पर्सनली बिलीव डांसर शुड हैव एवरीथिंग व्हाट द कंट्री ऑफर्स। यू जस्ट हैव टू बी केयरफुल व्हाट यू आर ईटिंग, हाउ मच यू आर ईटिंग एंड व्हेन यू आर ईटिंग, एज दैट्स व्हाट अ बैलेंस्ड डाइट इज कॉल्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू मी। डांसिंग कैन इम्प्रूव योर मूड व्हाइल यू लर्न मूव एंड परफॉर्म। इनफैक्ट मैनी पीपल टेक डांस क्लासेस बिकॉज दे पुट देम इन अ गुड मूड एंड पॉजिटिव मूड। डांस प्लेज एन वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन कीपिंग योर मेंटल हेल्थ इन चेक। इनफैक्ट लोग डांस इसलिए भी सीखते हैं या करते हैं ताकि उनका मूड अच्छा रहे और वो पॉजिटिव बने रहे। तो आइए इस इंफॉर्मेशन के साथ हम लोग अपनी नेक्स्ट मूवमेंट की तरफ चलते हैं, जिसमें हम आपको परफॉर्मेंस के बारे में दिखाएंगे, म्यूजिक, डांस और ये सब बातें किस तरह मिक्स एंड मैच होती है। आइए, I'm not afraid of the dark.
Stop. Yeah. Na 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 and all my dear friends, it is my privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this occasion. On behalf of Thirak, the dance club of AFGJI, I would like to first of all express my sincere thanks to Sri Karan Gangani ji, who spared time from his busy schedule to grace this occasion and showcase his exemplary classical dance skills with us all. I would also like to thank Sri Shubhi Johri ji, Amit Kichni ji and Abhishek Kichhi ji for their valuable input in the lecture demonstration. I express my gratitude to our respected principal ma'am for providing motivation, encouragement and support to carry out this work. I would also like to thank our dance teacher Sri Sandeep Lal ji for being a constant pillar of support and guidance in conducting this workshop. In conclusion, I thank all our teachers and students for making this workshop a success. Thank you all once again and have a good day.